Hi everyone, Said here. I hope you are doing great. In this video, we will be taking a look at how to use XLOOKUP function in Excel. In fact, with XLOOKUP, you don't need VLOOKUP, you don't need HLOOKUP, and even you don't need index match function. Today, I will take you through 5 examples that will help you understand XLOOKUP function completely. In the first example, we're gonna learn the basic of XLOOKUP. Its argument and how to write it inside the Excel. In the second example, we are going to learn how to return multiple columns and how to handle items not found. And in the third example, which is really interesting, I'm going to show you a two-way lookup. Lookup under rows and columns, and for that, we are going to use nested XLOOKUP. Instead of HLOOKUP, we are going to operate XLOOKUP to the horizontal data. And finally, I will show you how to look for an approximate match with XLOOKUP. Are you ready? Let's get to our 5 examples. We have a master list which all the students' names and specifications are in this list. In the next sheet, we only have some of the students' names, and we want to write the grade of them in the cell. So, I want to use the XLOOKUP function to return the student's grade in this cell. I write equal XLOOKUP. Excel shows me the function. So, I double click on it and you can see the argument. These 3 arguments are essential and others are optional. First, we need to input the lookup value. I am looking for this name, comma. Then you have to input the lookup array, which your lookup value should be in it. So I select the master list sheet, and Daniel Elliott is in this column. So I select this array and add comma. And for return array, you need to choose the array that your result is in it. I want the grade of a student, so I select this range. Since other parameters are optional, I leave them and press enter. Daniel Elliott is PhD candidate. If you look at the master list, you can see it too. Now, let's drag this formula to other cells. But there is a problem. What is it? Can you tell me? We forgot to make some referencing absolute. So let me press Ctrl+Z to undo that. I double click on the cell to edit my formula. I select lookup array in the argument and press F4 to absolute it. And select the return array and press F4 again. Now everything is perfect, so I press enter and drag the formula down. In this example, we need to return 2 parameters, a student ID number and age. So in this cell, I write equal XLOOKUP and double click on the formula. And I'm looking for this cell, comma. For the lookup array, I select master list sheet and select this array. And since I want to drag the formula down, I press F4 to absolute it, comma. And for returning value, this time I want the student ID and age. So I select this range and press F4 to absolute them and press enter. Excel automatically returns the ID and age in both cells. Now I can send them down. But I see an error in the list for Said Faal. It is because he is not in the list. I prefer to put a message inside the cell instead of error. So I press Ctrl+Z to undo that and double click on this cell to edit the formula. At the end of the formula, I add a comma to activate if not found section. And I write not in the list and press enter. Now if I drag the formula down, this time instead of error, you see not in the list inside this cell. In this example, we are going to perform two-way lookup. Lookup under rows and columns. And for that, we are going to use nested XLOOKUP. You can see the specific value. For example, if you want to see the meat consumption, In the China, you can easily find the value. I write equal XLOOKUP and I'm looking for this value, comma, and I'm selecting this array, comma, and for return array, you need to use another XLOOKUP. I write XLOOKUP again. This time I'm looking for China. So I select this cell, comma, and for the lookup array, I select this range, comma. For return array, I select the range of variables and close the parentheses and press enter. Now you can easily perform two-way lookup. For example, I select unemployment in this list and select Brazil in other list. Almost 10% of people in Brazil are unemployed. Or I select the world's economy in this list and select United States in other list. You can see that almost 23% of the world's economy is in the hand of United States. We used XLOOKUP inside the XLOOKUP. Maybe it is a little confusing. So let me explain it a little more. Let me show you a step by step what we did exactly. First, I write the inside this lookup. Equal XLOOKUP, I want to return China, so I select this cell, comma, and I select this array, comma, and I select the entire variables. This is the results. This is what the inside XLOOKUP calculates. In fact, with the inside XLOOKUP, the table's shape simplifies to this. Now, if I want to perform the XLOOKUP again, this time instead of the inside XLOOKUP, I can use this array. Let me show you. In this cell, I write equal XLOOKUP, and I'm looking for this value, comma. I select this range as lookup array, comma. And I select this range as the return array instead of inside XLOOKUP. In fact, we calculate the result in two steps. First, we calculate the inside XLOOKUP, and in the next step, we calculate the final result. But in the original function, we have nested two XLOOKUPs to get the result in one step and faster. In this example, we are going to use XLOOKUP for the horizontal variables. In this cell, I write equal XLOOKUP, and I'm looking for this ID number, comma. For the lookup array, I told you, you have to select the range that has this value in it. The value is in this range, so I select this range, comma. And I want to return salary, so I select this range for the return array. Now, if I select another ID number, I can see the result here. Isn't it awesome? You don't need XLOOKUP anymore. In this example, I want to calculate the tax rate for my salary, but we don't have $33,000 in the lease, so we need to look for the approximate match. I write XLOOKUP, I am looking for this value, comma, this is my lookup array, comma, and I want to return the tax rate, so I select this range. If I press enter, I will get an error because this number does not exist in the list. But if I want an approximate tax rate, I have to edit my formula. So I double click on it and add a comma at the end. But I don't want to make any change to if not found parameter. So I add another comma to pass it. And in match mode section, by default number 0 is selected, which is the exact match. But if you select minus 1, Excel will look for the exact match or the next smaller value. And if you select the number 1, Excel will look up for the exact match or the next larger value. And number 2 will look up for wildcard character match. In this case, I double click on minus 1 and press enter. Since Excel couldn't find the exact match, it represented the next smaller value. I hope you find all of these examples helpful. Please like and subscribe for the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. and leave comments for additional tips that you would like to see covered in the channel. Alright, it was all for today's video. I will see you in next video.